And next on the ice are the skaters currently in third place, Barbara Fusar-Poli and Maurizio Margaglio of Italy, the reigning world champions.
And now for something completely different. Skating to the music, I Will Survive. This piece is bound to get the audience involved. Going down there, and the weakness of this team has been Maurizio's technical skating and tripping him up there.
So is that significant as far as winning a medal here?
It is significant. First of all, it was on a required element, the straight line sequence. That's a mandatory 0.2 deduction. Secondly, when you've got that back in the back of your mind, it's hard to deliver with the rest of your performance. He's got to park it.
I have to say, Tracy, we've seen ice dancers fall before and apparently not have much effect on the scores.
Well, when you're in a fight like they are for a bronze medal, that should make the difference. Fusar-Poli and Maurizio Margaglio, they fought back valiantly in that performance, but they know how dear that mistake was. What a shame to have that happen at the Olympic Games. This team for many years as they climbed up the ladder. They were fifth back in 1999, and they dedicated themselves to training. They came on the 2000 season on fire. They had speed and fast footwork, and because of that, they moved to second in the world. Last year, they became world champions. But their material this year just hasn't taken them to where they wanted to go.
The Italian judge, Walter Zaccaro, has consistently ranked them higher than any of the other judges on the nine-judge panel.
For a team that their trademark was speed and footwork, it took them about 40 seconds at the beginning of their program to actually start skating. They wound into the program slowly with this lift, and I think they missed an opportunity to kind of go like gangbusters off the start, because that, of course, is their strength, their speed. Now let's take a look here at what happened in the diagonal footwork sequence. Maurizio does not do as many turns as Barbara. Normally she does a lot of the difficulty, and there he just got his toe pick caught. He was leaning slightly forward, off balance. He got up quickly. Get one more look at it, and you can see he just was not over his feet. He was leaning forward, couldn't get the blade underneath him, and obviously devastated.
Ero tranquillissimo, stavo andando bene. Ho sentito che era da Dio. Ho sentito da Dio perché.
So perhaps leaving the door open for the Canadians, Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz. Italian judge has submitted his marks.
Ciao a tutti.
Ciao a tutti in Italia. Third place, coming into the free dance, which counts 50%.
Ciao a tutti. Grazie, un attimo massimo, lo so. Dispiace tanto. Dispiace.
Barbara married to Italian short track speed skater Diego Patani, who competed in Nagano. He knows all about the Olympic experience.
Deduction taken on this first set of marks.
Italian 5'7", the highest of any. And 5'9" from the Russian judge. 5'8" the Italian.
I'm surprised they stayed ahead of the Lithuanians with that error in the program.